गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वेलकम टू स्वाति आईएएस अकेडमी। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द एमसीक्यूज ऑफ 5th जून, एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो जॉइन अस ऑन आवर टेलीग्राम चैनल वेर वी अपलोड ऑल दीज पीपीटीज, एंड यू कैन फाइंड द लिंक इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स ऑल्सो। सो लेट्स सी व्हाट आर द 10 टॉपिक्स विच वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन टूडेज लेक्चर। सो हियर इज द लिस्ट इज गिवन, एंड ट्राई टू गेट एटलीस्ट 7 क्वेश्चन करेक्ट आउट ऑफ 10। सो वर्क हार्ड, बी कंसिस्टेंट, रेगुलरली वॉच आवर वीडियोज। And let's begin our today's MCQs with question number 1. So question number 1 is with reference to Delimitation Commission of India. Statement first, Delimitation Commission is a constitutional body that redraws the boundaries of the various assembly and Lok Sabha constituencies. Second, the Delimitation Commission Act 2002 froze delimitation process till the first census after 2026. So here the correct option is B, that means statement first is incorrect because Delimitation Commission is not a constitutional body, it is a statutory body which was first established in India in 1952. And although Article 82 of the Constitution says that central government can set up a Delimitation Commission after every 10 years, however, the commission was only set up in 1952, 63, 75, and 2002, and the Indira Gandhi government had suspended delimitation in 1976 until the 2001 census, and the Delimitation Commission Act 2002 further froze the delimitation till the first census after 2026. And context is that Lok Sabha Speaker has nominated 15 MPs from Jammu and Kashmir, Assam, Manipur, Nagaland and Arunachal Pradesh to assist the Delimitation Commission in redrawing the Lok Sabha and Assembly constituencies of the Northeastern State and the UT Jammu and Kashmir. So do remember that Delimitation Commission is being set up under an act, so it is a statutory body, not a constitutional body. Now question number 2 is with reference to dredging. Statement first, it is the removal of sediments and debris from the bottom of lakes, rivers, harbors and other water bodies. Second, dredging causes no significant harm to environment and biodiversity. So here the correct option is A, because statement second is incorrect, as dredging disturbs natural vegetation and marine life, promotes riverbank erosion and creates unexpected land loss. Flooding can become much more severe as a result of dredging. And dredging of streams lowers the surrounding water table, dries up adjacent wetland, releases toxic chemicals, increases water turbidity and litter harmful metals throughout the food chain. And Dredging Corporation of India Limited is Mini Ratna public sector unit engaged in the business of dredging. And context is that the Andhra Pradesh government has directed to stop dredging in the Kakinada coast. Now question number 3 is with reference to THAAD missile system. Statement first, THAAD is an anti-ballistic missile system of USA. Second, USA has deployed THAAD in the South Korea as a countermeasure against China. So here the correct option is A, and statement second is incorrect because USA has deployed THAAD in the South Korea as a countermeasure against attacked by North Korea, not China. And THAAD stands for Terminal High Altitude Area Defense and is a transportable and ground-based missile defense system of USA. And once UPSC has also asked question regarding THAAD, which is an anti-ballistic missile system and was developed after the USA experiences in the Gulf War 1991. And THAAD has been deployed in Israel, Romania, UAE and South Korea. And also China has objected the presence of US THAAD missile system in South Korea. Now question number 4 is United Nations Security Council Resolution 1325 deals with which of the following? So the correct option here is B, that means role of women in the prevention and resolution of conflicts. So basically, resolution 1325 addresses two major points: the inordinate impact of violent conflict and war on women and children, as well as the crucial role that women should and already do play in conflict prevention, conflict resolution, peacemaking, and peace building. And four basic pillars of the resolution are participation, protection, prevention, and relief and recovery. And context is that Major Suman Gawani of the Indian Army, who served as a peacekeeper with the United Nations mission in the South Sudan in 2019, has won the prestigious United Nations Military Gender Advocate of the Year Award, and the award is given to recognize effort in promoting the principles within the resolution of 1325 and is award to the military peacekeeper who has best integrated a gender perspective into peacekeeping activities. So it's a positive news for India. Now question number 5 is Rozgar Setu scheme recently news has been launched by which of the following state of India? So the correct option here is C, that means Madhya Pradesh. And Rozgar Setu scheme is to act as a bridge between workers and employers so that both are benefited, and the objective is to provide work to the maximum number of returned skilled workers and bring them on a platform to connect them employers. And the scheme will survey skilled workers who are employed at industries elsewhere and have now returned back to the states. Now question number 6 is recently General Insurance Council was in news. Statement first, it is a part of the Insurance Association of India. Second, it regulates the growth of the general insurance industries. Third, it was established under the Indian Insurance Act 1938. Fourth, it is an important link between the IDA and the non-life insurance industries. So the correct option here is D, because all the given statements are correct. And GIC, that means General Insurance Council, also pushes for the country's industries issues with the government, and while the council plays the role and envisaged for it by the Insurance Act, it also facilitates overall growth for the industry in a fair and equitable manner in the interest of all stakeholders. And as per Section 64C of the Insurance Act 1938, all general insurer, health insurer and reinsurer granted registration and license by IDA to carry out business in India are member of GIC. Now question number 7 is recently line of actual control is constantly in news. Statement first, the LAC is the demarcation that separates Indian controlled territory from Chinese controlled territory. Second, it is divided into three sectors. Third, middle sector includes Ladakh, Uttarakhand and Himachal Pradesh. As we have to find out incorrect option here, so the incorrect statement here is third, so option will be C, because it is the western sector which include Ladakh, not the middle sector, and eastern sector includes Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim. And the alignment of the LAC in the eastern sector is along the 1914 McMahon line, and there are minor dispute about the position on the ground as per the principle of the High Himalayan watershed. The major disagreement are in the western sector, as India rejected the concept of LAC in both 1959 and 1962. Then India formally accepted the principle of LAC when Rao paid a return visit to Beijing in 1993, and the two signed agreement to maintain peace and tranquility in the LAC. We have also covered this issue of LAC between India and China in the Sunday series lecture. So if you haven't seen it, please go in the playlist of Sunday series and watch it. You will be benefited out of it. Now question number 8 is recently National Board of Wildlife was in news. Statement first, it is a statutory organization constituted under the Wildlife Protection Act. Second, its vice chairman is Minister of Environment. So the correct option here is C, meaning both the statements are correct. So theoretically, the board is advisory in nature and advises the central government on framing policies and measures for conservation of wildlife in the country. However, it is very important body because it serves as apex body to review all wildlife related matters and approve projects in and around national park and sanctuaries. And the chairman of national board for wildlife is prime minister, but the vice chairman is minister of environment. Now question number 9 is, which of the following country is not the part of G7 group? So you have to choose the country which is not part of G7 group. So the correct option is D, that means China is not part of G7, and it includes Canada, France, Germany, Italy, Japan, UK and US, and it is an intergovernmental organization that was formed in 1975 by the top economies of the time as an informal forum to discuss pressing world issues. And the G7 does not have a formal constitution or a fixed headquarters, and the decision taken by leaders during annual summit are also non-binding. And the rise of India, China and Brazil over the past few decades have reduced the G7's relevance, whose share in global GDP has now fallen to around 40%. So there are talks of including India in G7 group, that's why it was in news. Now question number 10 is, Gulf of Venice is present in which of the following water body? So the correct option here is A, that means Adriatic Sea. So as you can see in the map, it is the Gulf of Venice in Adriatic Sea, meaning the part of Mediterranean Sea. And it is a gulf that borders Italy, Slovenia and Croatia. Now today's question for you is, you have to tell, Pangong So Lake, which is constantly in news, is located in western sector, eastern sector or middle sector of LAC region. So that's all in our today's MCQs. Hope you guys are liking the lecture, and if you want to contact us, these are the details, and you can also contact us for the information regarding UPPSC examination and its test series. So stay safe, stay healthy, have a nice day and